Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you name these living things? Plants, animals, birds. Okay, plants, animals, birds, these are all living organisms, are living things we find in our India. Okay, just like this, if I keep asking you, I'm showing you a list of other living organisms also, like insects, fishes, all those. Now I will be showing one living organism. I want you to identify which is what is the uniqueness of amoeba?
It's a single celled organism. Single cell.
Only one cell. Don't you wonder why one cell can exist in the life? Would you feel? Have you not thought of it?
Yes, ma'am.
What kind of organism we are?
Multicellular.
So, then, whatever the way we live, you know, amoeba is living a life. Even if it is a living organism, with one cell, it is going to perform all of the functions. Now, along with amoeba, I'm showing the other one again.
Dolly. A group of cells.
Each cell, can you identify this cell function, this cell function, this? Can you able to recognize and label? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's one answer, yes. Now, we have only one cell function. Two multicellular organism, each cell will have a distinct, and where you can say this cell is this, maybe A is different, B is different, C is different, like that, can we label?
Yes, ma'am.
Monica? No. Why? How?
Group of
cells performs a function, isn't it? So what they call for the group of functions is going to perform a function?
Tissue.
Tissues. We call them the group of cells are specialized to perform particular function in multicellular organism, which we call as a tissues. Can you name the function of your tissues? What may we think of our body? What may be the different tissues which we have in our body and what may be their function? You said no? Everything is being happening with one cell. Whereas in multicellular, there are group of cells are going to perform particular functions.
That is somatic tissue.
Just list out any two functions which are going to be performed by tissue.
Tissue.
Yes, Tanusha?
Tissue will take care of.
Okay, fat, which is having particular purpose to do?
Movement.
Yes. Now I am moving my muscle. Is it so much paining for me?
No.
No, then which are the muscles, which are the tissues which are helping me to move?
Epithelial, muscular tissue.
Now you are all sitting with good posture. With our good posture?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, which are the tissues which are helping you to sit?
Skeletal muscles, sir. Skeletal tissue.
Muscular as well as skeletal. So it's supporting, right? So now come to it. Now it is unicellular, one cell functions everything, whereas in multicellular, group of cells functions, as you said. Consider now, this is also multicellular cell. See, there are group of cells. This cell, this is a picture of plant. Do the same thing happen with the plant?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Do plant need like separate cell functions or a group of cell functions together, certain specific activities?
Group of cells.
Group of cells specific activities. Now compare with plants and other
Yes, ma'am.
Also, as well as other organisms, as well as human beings, multicellular, to all activity. Do both of them perform particular functions to exist in a life?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what are those functions?
Respiration.
Digestion.
Ingestion.
Locomotion. You all need to note down this then?
Duty
function. So note down this, just think of it. Okay, then? Any other functions which is being performed by multicellular organisms?
Excretion or whatever, here.
Now, okay. Now you said locomotion, digestion, respiration. Do respiration happens in both?
Yes, ma'am.
Do digestion happens in both?
Yes, ma'am. No. Yes, ma'am.
Does the human beings? Yes, ma'am. Do the same thing happens with plants?
No, ma'am.
Then do they differ from the plants and animals? They differ in particular functions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Even though the tissues perform particular function, they differ. Now think of only plants. Now I got a plant. Now consider now this was a plant where I have just taken out from the root along with this root. If I plant it elsewhere, is it grows?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. As you are seeing in the picture, what kind of plant it is?
Hibiscus.
Anyway, I have taken hibiscus with a very thin part. We have put down the thicker one. If I take little more mature one, if I use this plant, treat in a hibiscus plant, is it resulting in a separate life existence?
No.
It is a part of the branch of the plant, right? But if I plant it elsewhere, it will grow into a new plant. So that means the tissues, whatever tissues are functioning in this plant, do they function every time the same function? Now when it is a part of the plant, it will have some function. Now I have taken it and I have made it plant elsewhere. Now do the same function it is going to do here?
Yes, ma'am.
Now there is no room for it. Can it survive?
No.
It need to, about the roots has to be developed from this, no? The same tissue which is going, like growing as a length, is the same tissue that helps you to grow the roots here?
Yes.
Can the same thing happen to human beings? If you cut one part, plant it, no other living, I am multicellular organism, this character existed. What tissue exactly responsible for this kind of nature of plants?
Meristematic tissue.
Yes, it is a meristematic tissue. Is it meristematic? What is the main function of meristematic tissue? Keep, so it will keep growing. And if it is a roots, it will keep growing. But again, then is it only meristematic tissue performs all the functions in plants?
No.
Yes?
Only growth.
Only some.
Is it only the tissue performs all the functions? No. Then what are the other group of tissues found in plants?
Xylem, phloem.
Yes.
There are other plant tissues which are going to perform specific function. So in today's class, let us learn about the plant tissues and its classification in the lesson tissues.
Biopontrol.